Eleanor Marks discovered this and became desperate with grief. Dr. Aveling then concocted a bizarre joint suicide pact involving the sequential taking of poisons. Only Eleanor Marks died. No criminal charges were ever brought against Dr. Aveling, who went to live with his actress in New York. During the time of the dispute over the Avelings' travel expenses in America, Engels never would hear a word of criticism against Dr. Aveling and continued to allot him choice bits of socialist literature to translate. Engels, supported by a sizable income from his father's estate, lived in a comfortable house at 122 Regent Street near Regent's Park, which was the center of the socialist community in London, which included authors, English reformers, and German and Russian intellectuals. Americans such as Henry Demarest Lloyd and William Derrick Kelly were well known in this community through their writings. With this far-flung group, writing was the glue of social cohesion. They all wrote books and essays, pamphlets, or tracts. They published letters in newspapers. Others commented upon what they published. They wrote letters to one another about one another, kept the letters, and often their own replies. They kept diaries. Then they kept much of their own writings and publications and gave them to libraries and archives. This was how Florence Kelly's letters to Engels ended up in Moscow. When Engels wrote a new preface to Die Lage, it included some remarks which could be interpreted as pointing to deficiencies in the leadership of the Socialist Labor Party, and some members of the executive committee in Hoboken took the criticism personally. The Socialist Labor Party didn't like the preface, and they neither endorsed it, nor promoted it, nor printed it, in spite of having received a subvention for its publication. They kept the money. There was suspicion among the Hoboken socialists of the Wisniewskis being agents of foreign socialism. Those who resisted the adoption of English distrusted Florence Kelly and her promotion of English as the language for American socialism. The fact that she herself was American and fluent in English was cause for distrust itself. Some suggested that she was a spy. It is not clear under whose auspices she would have been spying.